I cannot believe this.
That's cool, huh?
Because they know you ever since they were
a... Well, yeah, they think I'm going to feed them, so...
Come here, son. Come here.
You gotta be kidding me.
What we don't want is her to jump the fence.
Okay, Dan, I'm very happy that I'm able, in my 55 years of living in this planet Earth, to see such a beauty of nature, a crocodile, like a symbol of Australia, just like the kangaroo and the koala.
Yeah, well, I better let you know, these are alligators.
Alligators?
these are American alligators, so they're not Australian crocodiles.
Well, what's the difference between an alligator and a crocodile?
Well, here in Australia, we do have two species of crocodile. They're all crocodilians, of course. And we have the freshwater croc, and we have the saltwater crocodile. These are American alligators. So American alligator has a much more rounded snout. You can see that.
What's the difference between an alligator and the crocodile?
So if you look at his snout, that's more in a U shape. Whereas our crocodile snouts...
Yeah, U-shape.
Our crocodile snouts are much more V-shaped, but also too, they have two very different types of dentition, their teeth. Look at the alligator. Its bottom teeth fit into grooves of the top of their snout. So you only see the top set of teeth.
And I think this is, I don't know if a dumb question, but alligators are more easy to get friendly with?
Very, very much so. So alligators want to eat something about the size of their head or smaller. So if you think of it, an alligator wants to eat a turtle or a bird, a crocodile, Elvis the size, wants to eat you. Not you, but something as big as you. If not, a water buffalo. So a crocodile can eat a 1,000 kilo water buffalo.
And what about the crocodiles that we see at the Serengeti, you know, all in
Africa?
Down the Nile?
Yeah, they're just as big. So they're Nile crocodiles or West African crocs. So
they're those are crocodiles?
They're crocodiles, yep.
These guys, I mean, these are alligators.
American alligators live in the southern third of the states. So
yeah,
you think
Florida.
Florida, New Orleans.
And the Mississippi, Delta.
Yeah, exactly. I'm actually going there next year to catch alligators in May.
To bring it here?
No, just for fun.
So you're not a friend of these guys?
No, not at all. Alligators are great. When you're used to working with crocodiles like I am, alligators are completely different. And that's because a crocodile will literally try and kill you for food, whereas the alligator doesn't want to do that. It knows you feed him. It knows if it comes over, you'll reward it.
So this is a species, let me practice my English,
that's
man,
okay.
Please.
That's okay.
That is very close to being domesticated then.
Oh, no, not domesticated.
But in the evolution, you know? Because they let humans feed them.
Feed them, yeah. But
you won't do that with a crocodile.
We still feed the saltwater croc, but he doesn't really want that little bit of food. The alligator's happy with the little bit of food, whereas the saltwater crocodile would much prefer something
big.
Yeah. They eat everything from a kangaroo all the way up to water buffalo size or a horse. So you're talking about an animal that can eat something that literally weighs 1,000 kilos, as big as they are. But they don't eat the whole thing.
They like to pick somebody that is, or some animal that is as big as they are.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Because if they can eat enough in that one meal, the crocodile doesn't have to eat for 2 months, 3 months, 12 months.
Come on, you gotta be kidding. Yeah. And what about the story about evolution, that these guys have been around for millions of years?
About 250 million years is when the first crocodile-like animals started. The crocs we're looking at today, about 65 million years, virtually unchanged. So 65 million years of evolution, almost unchanged, and that's because, well, they're perfect. They're as close to perfect as you can get. They outlived the dinosaurs.